you're getting married soon, or maybe your brother is getting married, your sister, your enemy, your uncle's father's daughter, your whoever is getting married in your life, or you just want to be entertained by the lessons I learned from my wedding, then keep watching. Hey you, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adenike Uncut. I am a movie and lifestyle vlogger. So if you want to be entertained by movie reviews, movie related content, or lifestyle content, entertainment generally, just subscribe to the channel, hit that red button, and I promise you a great time. It's not news anymore that I recently got married and it was quite an experience. Glory of God, the wedding took place, and regardless of all the advices that I got and all the recommendations and all the books and blogs that I read, there were still quite a few things I wish I had handled better. I'm going to be sharing those things with you, lessons I learned from my wedding, so you do not make the same mistake. Today is all about Aso Ebi, Aso Ebi Bella, Aso Ebi gang, Aso Ebi bridesmaids, Aso Ebi groomsmen, Aso Ebi parents, Aso Ebi siblings. If you want one advice from me, don't do Aso Ebi. But if you are anything like me, then you are very stubborn, and what you want to do, you will do it. So if you still decide, despite the fact that I just told you not to do Aso Ebi, if you still decide that, you know what, Nike, I'm not gonna listen to you, I still want to do Aso Ebi, then keep watching. I believe Aso Ebi started from the fact that, you know, siblings or family members all want to wear the same thing for a ceremony. So Aso Ebi is not necessarily for weddings alone, you know, for burial parties, for birthday parties, for anything, for graduation. I mean, any ceremony you are having, you can decide to go ahead and do Aso Ebi. And there's that need for people to want to belong. I want to be able to relate to the celebrant or to the bride or to the groom in a particular way. And so because of that, I want Aso Ebi. These were the things I did not know about Aso Ebi, and I learned the very, very hard way during my wedding. Number one, I did not know that when people buy Aso Ebi from you, they believe that they are gifting you something. They believe they are giving you your wedding gift. You know that, and I learned the hard way, because I just didn't get why, you know, someone would say, oh, you know, I don't have any money to support your wedding, but I'll buy Aso Ebi. And I'm like, that makes absolutely no sense. Number two, people can buy your Aso Ebi, they still not come for your wedding. In fact, people will buy your Aso Ebi without any intention of coming for the wedding, but they just buy it because they believe buying the Aso Ebi means they have gifted you something and they've contributed to your wedding in a certain way. I want you to be there looking beautiful in this dress and in this color, and that was why I gave it to you and I sold it to you, but apparently that's not what you think. You think it's okay for you to buy it and then not come, not because of, you know, extraordinary circumstances or whatever work, blah, 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 but just because you figure, ah, oh, right, well, Aso Ebi should be all right. If you are not going to come for the wedding, don't buy Aso Ebi. Number three, this was one that I don't know how I just did not know this. Maybe because I've never been one to buy Aso Ebi or, you know, to attend parties per se or whatever, but I just didn't know. Apparently, when you're selling Aso Ebi, you're supposed to add your own money to it. So if the fabric costs 10,000 naira, maybe gele cost 2,000 naira, that's 12,000 naira. Souvenir cost 3,000 naira, that's 3K, right? You're supposed to add another maybe 5K, 10K, 25K. So what you do is you look at the pockets of the people you are selling to. You now, this was what I did not know. You look at the pockets of the people you are selling to, you now say, ah, maybe I think these people will be able to afford it. So you now sell it to them, and maybe something that cost you 15K, you sell it at 30K. I did not know. So I went ahead and sold my Aso Ebi and gele at the price that the Aso Ebi woman gave to me. So I didn't know, I didn't do that. And that kind of made me feel right now like I was duped. People were telling me, oh, you can make millions of naira, you can make hundreds of thousands of naira on Aso Ebi. Number four, even if people buy your Aso Ebi for 1,000 naira, they are still expecting souvenir. I don't get it. How now? People will complain, oh, Aso Ebi is too expensive, whatever. But apparently, if you sell Aso Ebi and you don't put souvenir, there's a problem. Hello? How much did you pay for the Aso Ebi? Oh, it was 2,500 naira. And you still wanted souvenir. Number five, people will rather buy Aso Ebi than give you money for your ceremony. Oh, I'm getting married. Oh, you know, I don't have money to support you right now. I'm so sorry. But you have Aso Ebi, Abi. How much is it? Oh, it's like 15K. Oh, 15K. No, wahala. Send me account number. I say, but I don't support you. I can buy Aso Ebi. You said what? Number six, let me just add this. I'm not sure if this applies to everybody or if it was just my own personal encounter, but people feel like they are doing you a favor when they buy you Aso Ebi. After all, I bought you Aso Ebi. Nami Bogera, it's not your clothes. Still, it's still a halal. Like, I'm speechless. Number seven, unless you're ready to go blind. Unless you're interested in going crazy, unless you're just interested in just being overwhelmed, then don't sell your Aso Ebi by yourself. This one was a lesson I learned before I actually started selling Aso Ebi or whatever, and I had someone who was helping me with it. But along the line, she had a few things happening to her, and she just needed to concentrate. She couldn't keep on handling the Aso Ebi, so she had to hand it back to me for me to handle myself. People, what a very interesting experience. I don't think I've ever calculated math the way I calculated it when I was selling Aso Ebi. What a stressful experience. I remember Toto was asking me at some point, and he was like, is that the last one? Please don't sell anymore after this. And I was like, I'm not selling again. And so I don't think it's worth the troubles. If I had to do it again, I would not have done Aso Ebi for my wedding. I would have just picked a color. A friend of mine did that, and her wedding was superb. It was beautiful. I would have just picked a color, wear what you have. If you don't have, wear black and come. Wear white and come. Come naked. Now you sabi. I know some of you are getting married. I know some of you are married already. Like, let's continue the lessons down below so others can learn from our mistakes, or, you know, whatever it is. Let's just continue the conversation in the comment section. Remember to subscribe. Have you subscribed to this channel? You need to be subscribed. Please just hit that red button, and I hope to see you again very, very soon. Thank you once again for watching. Remain in God. God bless you. Mwah.